God may ask you to go through various type of suffering. Don't lose courage. In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 25, there was a young woman. Her name is Abigail. This young woman is from the family of a priest. And who is a priest? Priest is the one who goes to the temple every day, offers the blood of the lamb. So, sacrifice life is known to Abigail. And this woman, God made her to get married to a man who is called Nabal. And who is this Nabal? 25th chapter verse 3 says, the man named Nabal, his wife Abigail. The woman was very intelligent. The woman was most beautiful. Look at what are the characters the Bible says. The woman was more intelligent, most beautiful. But the man himself, he remained a celibate. He was rough and ill-mannered. And he was always mad after money. He never understood the physical need of his wife. She was intelligent. She was beautiful. And she is married to that wealthy man. But that wealthy man, he remains in the field making bread and making money. And he is a very rough man. This woman is married into that family. And she remains. Life might have been tough. One day, David and his men, they come on their way. They ask for bread. David is a young man. His wife just left him. And now Abigail's husband Nabal says, when they came for bread, they say, all this waste fellows, useless fellows who are roaming in the street, I should give bread? Is it for them I made bakery? Go, get lost. He chased them away. When the people went and told David, this man could not feed the hungry people, we will go and kill him. They planned. Now this news reached the wife of Nabal, Abigail, who is the most beautiful woman, who is an intelligent woman, whose husband is a rough fellow, whose husband doesn't understand the needs of the wife, who never comes home. But this young, beautiful, intelligent woman takes cakes, bread, and everything, all kinds of cashew nuts, all kinds of things in her home, whatever was there. They were rich people, carrying in so many ashes. And as soon as she reached David, she kept her head below, between two of the knees, and she never showed her face, because this young man can attract her and lead her to the lust. So she kept up her faithfulness to her husband. I have said yes to my God, and I am going to meet a young man, and I need his favor. I have to go and protect my husband. That's all matters to me. She never showed her face. She shouted. And in every statement, he brought the name of the Lord. David, you are a servant of the Almighty God. Today, in spite of all your problem against Saul, against Nabal, whomever may be, God is protecting you. God, God, God. That the man should never enter into lust. Because she is a single woman. She called upon the Lord. She remained faithful to her husband. Yes. For her, cross means. She's a beautiful woman. Her husband never loved her. She's a young woman going to meet a young man who has lost his wife. Easily she can get in involved with him because her own husband doesn't come and fulfill her needs. Her husband never bothers her. But what happens to me in the world doesn't matter. Where God has kept me, I have to save my husband. He is my husband, whatever may be. For her cross means to do the will of God. Many things she could not understand why these things are happening. And within no time, the husband died. And then David, who lost his wife, when he came to know that Nabal is no more, he comes home and asks Abigail, "Will you become my wife?" Abigail, a great woman of God, says, "I will pray to God. I will pray to God." She prayed, and then she becomes the wife of David. My dear friends, for us, cross means not the world, not the worldly pleasure. That which is passing away cannot rule us, cannot take away that which is eternal, that which is life-giving. We read in the book of Romans, chapter 11, verse 18. Take care, that which is eternal, that which is life-giving, to which you belong to, is not destroyed at the cost of that which is perishing. Yes, that which is perishing, the lust of this world.